In 2006, Lotto released the world's first laceless football boot, the Zhero Gravity, and 13 years later, they've done it again. Released a new laceless boot. Obviously, it's not the first one because that was the first one, but it's a new laceless boot. They haven't made one in a long time, and it's what's going on, guys? Josh from SoccerReviewsForYou.com, bringing you my review plus on-feet video of the brand new and quite frankly very exciting Lotto Solista 100 Gravity, Lotto's first laceless football boot in a very long time that quite frankly is a lot better than I was expecting and actually one of the best laceless football boots I've ever worn. And I have to be honest with you guys, when these were first unveiled a couple months ago, I kind of had it in the back of my mind along with the excitement that there's a strong possibility that these are going to be absolute trash. To my surprise, that is not the case, and I would actually go as far as saying that this might be the best laceless football boot on the market, better than any of the laceless stuff currently on offer from the Adidas brand, which is the comparison that needs to be made and will be made in today's video. We're gonna go over the tech specs as well as how they fit and feel on feet. So if you're interested in learning more, please stick around, watch the entire review. And if you're interested in a pair for yourself, I'll leave a little pop-up on screen, or you can click the first link down below. That'll take you to the review page on my website, where you'll be able to pick these up along with exclusive SR4U coupon codes below their normal 180 euro retail price. If you guys do end up enjoying this video and perhaps would like to see more reviews of smaller brands like Lotto that have actually come out with some pretty interesting boots over the last couple of weeks, don't forget to support this one with a like and let me know specifically what you want to see down below in the comments. Also, if you're new here watching for the first time and don't want to miss out on daily football boot content from me, make sure you hit that subscribe button along with the little bell notification so you get notified when the next new video goes live. So included with the boots is a Solista Gravity branded box, and inside that box you get a variety of extras. The first of which is this piece of paper that gives you some technical information about the boots as well as a visual history of laceless boots within the Lotto brand. They also include what I would describe as an insole wallet that contains a couple of different things. The first of which is a shoehorn to help with putting the boots on, given the fact that they are laceless. They also include an extra set of insoles that aren't actually insoles. You can see they are labeled as double fit, and this is a 2mm piece of slightly firmer foam that is actually designed to sit underneath the regular soft foam insoles inside of the boots to help cut down on any kind of volume. Because the boots are laceless and you can't adjust them in any way, this allows you to get that slightly tighter fit if you need it. Here's the paper that explains exactly what I just explained. And they also include a string bag that, unlike the boots, is not laceless, but is actually really good quality. You can see it's black in color with this unique kind of open mesh design here towards the top of the bag. It has the Lotto logo and the Solista Gravity branding there on the front, nothing on the back. It gets a string bag score of 2014 out of 2075. As for the boots themselves, the key feature here is obviously the fact that these are laceless, a concept that Lotto actually introduced to the football boot industry first back in 2006 with the Zhero Gravity, a football boot that many would argue was ahead of its time and never really caught on for various reasons. It also kind of marked the beginning of the end for the Lotto brand and its more significant popularity that it had at that point in time. They kind of disappeared for a number of years, and then 10 years later, Adidas would obviously popularize laceless football boots with the Ace 16 Plus Pure Control that was extremely well received and obviously has sparked a lot of laceless boots within the Adidas brand. So some would argue that Lotto was copied by Adidas, and then when you look at the Lotto Solista 100 Gravity, you might say, hey, this looks like a copy of an Adidas boot, and there's no denying, I wasn't prepared for this, that this new Lotto boot looks a whole lot like the current Predator 19 Plus. And while technically Lotto did do the whole laceless thing first, in comparison to the Predator, they're both knitted boots, they're both laceless designs, they have very similar cuts, and actually the shape of the two boots aren't too off from each other either. But despite all the similarities, I would actually argue that the Lotto does the whole laceless thing quite a bit better. With the Solista 100 Gravity, at least as far as I'm aware, being the first full knitted upper that we've seen from the Lotto brand. This material being called their Evo Elastic Mesh material. And you can see it does have a knitted construction visually represented with the translucent polyurethane top layer, so you can actually see the knitted material itself. And it also has a little bit of a ribbed texturing to it, kind of like the speed ribs we saw on the Superfly 5 with its Flyknit upper, but the speed ribs, or the ribs in this situation, running the length of the boot rather than directly across. As far as the feel of this knitted upper is concerned, it's super soft, it's super pliable, and reminds me a lot of the Prime Knit synthetic found on the current Predator 19 Plus. It's relatively thin, it has a padded feel to it. It is lined with a soft microfiber material on the inside, and the top layer is a polyurethane with a little bit of kind of a slightly soft waxy finish to it, not really providing much in the way of extra grip on the ball, but certainly not being slippery either. Which brings us to the actual laceless system, and I have the Predator side by side with the Solista 100 Gravity, just so you can see that they did more or less copy exactly what Adidas has done with their laceless design on the Predator. However, there is one key difference, and that is the fact that they've gone with a thin layer of polyurethane on the surface that might seem insignificant, but goes a long way in terms of providing a lot of extra lockdown, especially through the midfoot. What Lotto has done is still used an elasticated knitted material across the top of the foot that admittedly has a very similar design, but they've reinforced the midfoot and lower part of the laceless system with this polyurethane material, preventing it from overstretching. So you can see even when I push my thumb on it, it just doesn't stretch nearly as much. And maybe it's hard to see from this particular angle, but if you were to have this boot on one foot and the Predators on the other, trust me when I say there is a noticeable difference in terms of overall tightness and certainly lockdown through the midfoot area of the boot. And because this isn't stretching upon, I guess, more intense movements, your heel stays more firmly locked in place as well. I'm not gonna go as far as to say that the lockdown is phenomenal, because it's not. It's still a laceless boot. There is still stretch to this area of the foot, where if it had a lacing system, those issues wouldn't necessarily be as significant as they are. But as far as laceless football boots go, Predator 19 Plus, or really any other boot you want to compare it to, this is some of the best lockdown I've ever had from a laceless football boot, period. Moving to the rear, you will find that these do feature a mid-cut design with this extended kind of elasticated material for a collar, very similar to other mid-cut boots we've seen from a variety of different brands at this point, basically there for the sake of looks, and it kind of plays into the whole sock-like laceless design of this particular football boot, but no real performance benefit to it at all. There is some internal structure around the heel, but also an external heel counter, something that I really like about this particular design. And then internally, it has a heel liner, again, very similar to the Predator in terms of being a nice, soft, synthetic suede slash microfiber material with a decent amount of padding for pretty good comfort. The insoles are pretty straightforward, featuring a very soft microfiber material as a liner on the surface, and it's made from a single layer of this black foam that actually has some pretty good density to it. So it's not particularly squishy, but soft enough to where it does feel slightly padded underfoot. And then again, they do give you the double fit inserts inside of the box if you feel like you need to cut down on some extra volume inside of the boots. Basically, you'd remove the regular insoles, you'd put the orange ones in, and then put the regular insoles on top to basically add thickness under your foot to help cut down on any extra volume for the sake of having a slightly better fit. Moving to the base, you'll find a pretty typical Lotto sole plate and stud pattern, this being directly taken from the previous generation Solista and also found on the Maestro 200, which I have reviewed on the channel, a very underrated pair of football boots. It's admittedly very sprint frame-esque, but something that Lotto has been doing on their football boots, at least variations of this design, basically since 2006, even before that. So it's not something that I would say is a copy of anything. It's got a nice lightweight feel to it, pretty high quality plastic. It does feature their signature Punto Flex design in the forefoot that is supposed to allow for better flexibility as well as this kind of spring back effect, which is hard to say that it really is that noticeable, but something that is a signature of the Lotto brand. And as far as the stud pattern is concerned, it's pretty much all conical studs. There are some Pac-Man shaped ones as well that I really don't think make for any added grip. They pretty much feel like conical studs. There's a bladed support stud in the middle. But again, despite looking very traditional, the traction that you get from this is actually a little bit more aggressive than you might expect, and great for use on firm natural grass. So I already mentioned that the upper has a lot of similarities to that of the Predator 19 Plus, but with better fit and better overall lockdown. The weight is another issue that I have with the Predator 19 Plus, and this is significantly lighter despite having a lot of similarities. In a size 9.5 US, the Solista 100 Gravity weighs in at 7.35 ounces. the equivalent of 208 grams, which is basically 2 ounces lighter than the Predator 19 Plus in the exact same size, which is very, very impressive and pretty much a weight that puts it on par with all the top speed boots currently available. Now, because Lotto have added basically a reinforcement to the laceless system, it doesn't stretch as much, which means that they're a little bit trickier to put on, certainly in comparison to the Predator 19 Plus. Still the same method though. I like to turn sideways, kind of get my foot in, and then use my back thumb as a shoehorn. If you want to use the actual shoehorn they include, that's fine too. And then just kind of pull it in. It's not overly difficult, but again, the opening is a little bit tighter than most other laceless boots. On feet, they actually feel a lot like the Predator 19 Plus, but with more tension, especially through the midfoot area of the boot, meaning that they're just a little bit tighter, but still feel very sock-like. It's a very natural sensation to have such a soft, flexible upper that moves with your foot very nicely. I think the sole plate is a little bit more flexible versus what you'll find on the Predators as well. And in general, the boots are very comfortable out of the box. There really isn't anything to break in because the upper is so soft to begin with. As far as the lockdown is concerned, it still suffers from the typical laceless boot issues in that when you bend your foot, your heel kind of tends to lift a little bit because there's nothing truly pushing it down and holding it in place. Not to the point where your heel is slipping so much that you're going to get blisters or the boots are going to feel uncomfortable, but they just don't have the tight locked-in sensation that a lot of other football boots with a lacing system will provide. But that's something that you kind of accept when you go the laceless route. As far as fit and shape is concerned, it's a very similar silhouette, I would say, to that of the Predator 19 Plus, lower volume in general. Currently, I'm wearing them without the extra insoles underneath the regular insoles. I just don't feel the need to use them. They fit tight enough as is, but that's something you can play around with once you actually have the boots on your feet, just to figure out what works best for you. In general, I would say if you have really wide feet, probably not a great option, but I think most people will be able to get them on. Whether or not they fit you perfectly, it's something that you're gonna have to find out once you actually get the opportunity to try them on yourself. As far as sizing is concerned, I'm wearing these in my usual size 9.5 US, and the fit and length is perfect. So if you're looking to order a pair for yourself, I would strongly recommend going true to size in order to achieve the best possible fit. So in conclusion, being somebody that has been highly critical of laceless football boots, as regular viewers of this channel might already know, I'm actually coming away very impressed with the Solista 100 Gravity. I'd go as far as to say that it's the best laceless boot that Lotto as a brand has ever produced. And I'll even go a little bit further to say that it is now one of only two laceless boots that I would actually be happy to wear throughout the course of an entire season, the other being the Adidas Copa 19 Plus. I'm not thrilled at the fact that Lotto have clearly taken inspiration from the Predator 19 Plus with this particular boot, but with that said, given the design similarities between the two, this just does a better job of being a knitted upper laceless football boot. It really does provide that sock-like experience on another level versus the Predator 19 Plus that I recently said was the most sock-like football boot you can buy. This is that one level higher with better lockdown and better responsiveness. And don't get me wrong, it still suffers from the typical laceless boot flaws and that there is inevitably some stretch across the top of the foot upon more intense movements. The heel lockdown does suffer because of this as well. But if you've worn laceless boots in the past and don't necessarily need your boots to feel as tight as possible, that's not gonna be an issue for you. And if anything, you're probably gonna come away impressed with how good the fit and lockdown is for a laceless football boot, not to mention the sole plate stud pattern, the outsole as a whole, not to mention the lighter overall feel to the boot, is another huge improvement over the Predator 19 Plus. So as far as laceless football boots go, especially ones with a full knitted upper, this is the best one you can buy. And I guess I should also mention that while they're not cheap, they are a lot cheaper than the current top-end Adidas laceless boots. Anyways, guys, that's it for my review. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to support it with a like. Again, if you're interested in a pair of these for yourself, you can click the first link down below. That's gonna take you to the review page on my website where you'll find buy it now links with exclusive SR4U coupon codes where you'll be able to pick these up below their normal 180 euro retail price. If you have any questions, as always, leave them down below in the comment section, and I'll do my best to get an answer out to you as soon as I possibly can. Subscribe if you haven't already for daily videos on all the latest and greatest soccer gear. You can find all my social media information linked down below in the description as well. And other than that, guys, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.